It is Water Cooler Wednesday.
And here today, Sheila Whalum with the Whalum Center for Music at Visible College. She's also, of course, the author of the books Why Men Cheat and Why Love Doesn't Last.
Yeah.
Plus, WREG's own Corey Ventura and Myron May is from the What's Happening Myron radio show and blog. Good to see you, folks.
Good morning. Thank you. We have a lot to talk about. Let's get right to it. Actor Kirk Cameron is stirring up a little controversy with his conservative views on marriage. Now, in an interview with the Christian Post, the outspoken evangelical said, quote, wives are to honor and respect and follow their husband's lead, not to tell their husband how he ought to be a better husband. He goes on to say, and I'm again quoting here, when each person gets their part right, regardless of how their spouse is treating them, there's hope for real change in their marriage, he says. Cameron is currently on a national speaking tour focused on Christian marriage called Love Worth Fighting For. He and his wife have been married for 25 years. So Sheila, of course, you and your husband, the Reverend Kenneth Whalum Jr., yes, are well known for your outspoken views on marriage. You don't hold back. So what do you think about it?
I agree with him totally.
Why?
I agree. Mainly because as a Christian, I believe in what the Word of God says in the book of Ephesians. It talks about wives submitting to their husbands. Mainly that the husbands love their wives and the wives respect their husbands. If you have that kind of agreement, you can make it 25 years for them, almost 34 years for me. It works.
So you don't listen to the obey part and see that as subservience.
Well, you can say obey or submit. And again, that scripture, as a Christian now, people, I always say in the marriage, you do whatever you think you need to do to make it work. But for my marriage, as a Christian, I believe in it. Submit means to submit to your husband. Some people like to say obey, you know, but that scripture also talks about the husband being the head. It's not 50-50 in marriage. No, no. It could be 60-40 where the husband is the head of that union. And that's what I believe.
So, Corey, Kirk Cameron's views, are they outdated? Are they antiquated? Are they perhaps needed?
Wait a second. Right? Okay, so I respect my husband and my husband respects me. I follow my own lead, though. So that's where I stand on that.
So the obey part, submitting part,
kind
is a little bit.
Kind of rubs me the wrong way.
Yeah.
Well, Myron, you're looking over here at us. Like you got something you got to say. That's it. Put it on the table.
Over here. And, you know, basically for the most part, the natural order of things, of course, as we've always been taught, you know, the man is the head of the household. The husband's the head of the household. However, you know, it all goes to being a good leader.
And but what if you're not?
Great.
That's
leader,
my point. What if you're married to a guy who's not like you?
Well, as Kirk Cameron said, when everybody
isn't a good leader.
I'm saying he is a good leader.
When everybody gets their part correct, everything falls in order. But it goes back basically to choices.
Though that's the question.
To choices. And if you choose the wrong leader, that's something you have to
do. You've given us a lot to think about. We've got to keep it moving here.
Okay. All right. Well, how about this one? Real estate tycoon and Shark Tank star Barbara Corcoran has some interesting advice for women entrepreneurs. She tweeted that wearing bright colors and hiking up her skirt works for her. Yeah, it is 2016. She finds being a woman running a business in a man's world a huge advantage. It isn't the first time she's shared some information that's a little bit unconventional in this regard. In 2009, she did an interview that she said she had a sales strategy that incorporated being, quote, slightly inappropriate, and went on to say she sometimes makes sure that the man knows he's attractive and touches him and that sort of thing. Corey.
You tend to get to where you want to go if you're remembered. And she tends to be remembered all the time.
But in what way? I mean, do you agree with her?
Slightly inappropriately sometimes.
Do you agree with that strategy?
I think hiking up a skirt is not something that I would do, clearly.
Unless your husband told you to. No, I'm kidding. I'm just joking.
But I mean, she's very successful, and I think she knows how to work it without crossing the line. And I think that's the balance.
All right, Myron.
And Myron.
Well, of course, I agree. Bright colors, I would definitely choose the bright colors, but she's like old enough to be my, I don't know, mother. So, you know, I kind of have mixed feelings on that. So one side of me agrees, the other side just want to gouge my eyeballs out. No, that's just a joke. I'm sorry.
Sheila, entrepreneur that you are,
I totally agree with her. I mean, be your
Sheila,
really, I believe you need to be exactly who you need to be. If you're a beautiful woman, be a beautiful woman. Wear exactly what you want to wear. I'm a preacher's wife, a first lady. I do what I need to do to be successful in life, to be beautiful to my husband. It doesn't matter about other people. This woman is a billionaire. It's all about power and money. I also read an article where it talks about a woman, a beautiful woman is like the stock market, just fantastic, you know? Mm-hmm. What's wrong with it? Nothing's wrong with it. Men like seeing beauty all day long.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Doesn't it sort of sell yourself short? Like,
I don't think
like
so.
You're your appearance rather than your brain?
Well, I think, no.
Beauty and got some brains.
Beauty and brains actually go together. You know, I retired from the city as the deputy director of finance. I was in the investment side of it.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been in all of that. Men mm-hmm. love that. But it's not that I did anything wrong. I always maintained who I was as this businesswoman for the city. You know, but you have to know how to dress. That's all. Don't be totally inappropriate. But
so hiking up your skirt's okay.
Well, that's just one piece of it.
All right, we'll keep it moving here. There's a social media war between comedian Amy Schumer and a man who recorded a video selfie with her on the street as she lashed out at him online, saying he scared her and that he took the selfie even after she told him not to. He told her, "This is America, and if you see a celebrity, you take a selfie." He went on to say, quote, "We have selfie sticks for it, and this is what our culture is." So what we want to talk about really is this our culture today, Myron? Is this where we are?
Yes, and we don't care. We want a picture.
Is it okay? Because you're a celebrity.
It isn't. Yeah, because, you know, people are always wanting to take their pictures with me all the time. No,
surely they
are. No. But seriously, you know, even out in public, even though they are public figures, if they don't want to be, you know, photographed, mm-hmm. you know, I think we should respect that.
Mm-hmm. So, Sheila, what about it? Should there be boundaries or?
Well, again, we are in the age of millennials, mm-hmm. ages 18 to 33, mm-hmm. and they're the largest group of everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And we're in a whole different world, a whole different culture. It is what it is. And so we can't say, really, there are no rules. Let's put it like that. There are no rules. So, no, I agree with the guy. Take the picture, you know. It is what it is.
Last word, quickly.
I mean, it's not just in America because, I mean, you have over in, with the Queen, with London, as well as the Pope. They take photos first and then actually talk to the person who's in front of them. So, unfortunately, it is where we are today. I just think maybe they didn't realize that Amy was upset about it.
All right. Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
We'll have you back. Okay.
Thank you.